Psychic ability. Now many people think they have a lot of psychic ability, and especially healing systems like pranic healing, Reiki, they promote the idea of psychic ability. Now please understand, psychic ability is some people have a very natural gift to the psychic ability. Many people have to train lifetime after lifetime in their psychic ability before they understand anything across. For example, I saw a psychic video today. He is telling, "I am able to see your father behind you. He is saying sorry to you." He is telling that he was not communicative when you come to him at the time of his death. In fact, he can give all the details about the personal life of the person. So they asked him in the interview, "Do you think your sisters and other people have the psychic ability?" He said very clearly, "No, the psychic ability has come for me and my mother and my grandmother. In fact, my sister never used to have that psychic ability. She always used to say, 'I am making up my psychic ability,' and he used to go on telling to people that I am making up my psychic ability." So the problem with many people is they don't realize that they are not naturally gifted. For example, you have read Science, Max, you have not practiced any psychic ability. How will you ever become successful in psychic ability all of a sudden? Now, this is something of conning people. Now, for example, I saw the video of one of the great Tai Chi master, Robert Peng. He was picked up from the very early age. He was trained by his teacher and he was able to bring the energy out of the hands long back. The problem with many people is, now he has practiced for a number of years before he could develop that such level of psychic excellence. In fact, he cures people in Australia. But the problem with many people is they have no idea that the psychic ability has taken a number of years for Robert Peng to work. He has begun long even before you are even thinking about it as a person. So many pranic healers and many people have a very wrong notion. Just because they believe it, just because they understand it, it means they have a psychic ability. Far from that, it is absolutely wrong. In fact, I went to one of the pranic healing classes. I got so bugged because they were telling all kinds of lies. They were lying to each other in the name of psychic ability. There's a guy who was telling, "I'm able to see the chakra and aura." Another guy came up with the story. He said, "Even the tables and chair have aura and chakra. Can you see the Mooladhara chakra of the table? Can you see the Moola Swadhisthana chakra of this and that?" I was beginning to ask myself, now will the table will have a Swadhisthana chakra? It is not possible. At least any living creatures can have seven chakras, not the immobile things across. Such is the level of corniness. In fact, I met one lady. Now Master Cho was alive, was conducting a workshop. In fact, Master Cho claimed that he never had any psychic ability, though I believed it is far from truth. The problem is that lady started telling that she had a lot of psychic ability because she believed it. Now he asked how much percentage of the aura, the golden light has come. Simply they'll say 70%. Now what is the measurement? What measurement do you have as a person? Then I realized it is all a con game which is continued year on year, month on a month, just to convince people and to feel that they are better than others. It is like money. It is like car. It is like movie. Now the new game which is getting fascinated with the entire thing is this. that they want to feel that they are spiritually superior to somebody. Now earlier it was like black Americans and white Americans. Now it is the red Indians and the white Indians. Now it is who is more spiritual. Am I more spiritual or you are less spiritual across? Now, for example, all these people do not have any spiritual background. They must have come after the age of 30, after they got married, after they got children, and after they have come into the age where what we call it as the time in which the soul turned towards more towards the spiritual light of God. They must have got involved after the 40. But all the time they are going on thinking that they are very spiritual cats, holy cat. They see their guru behaving, so they believe in psychic ability. The ultimate con is, I saw somebody talking about astral travel. They went to astral travel, it seemed. They went to the house, they had a coffee, they put a coffee and they came. Now, how will you prove it? Nobody can prove it. So the point is, please do not talk about the level of Guru Padmasambhava, Matsyendranath, all those levels across. It is all con. It is all con. Nobody has a debility. Those big sadhus must have meditated in their past life for years together to develop such kind of abilities. So please do not waste your time in claiming a lot of things which are not true. Asatya is one of the biggest problem in the spiritual life. I see a lot of gurus who develop a lot of marketing abilities, marketing people, because they want to make money out of it. So don't think, for example, intuition, to follow intuition will take a lot of time, will take a lot of guts. It will take a lot of time to keep on following the intuition, because it will take you to wrong spaces. It will take you to really a testing time. So actually people are following the habit. Intuition will break the habit across. Now, for example, you're seeing spirits for the first time. You will find it very, very difficult to take it across. For the first time I saw some yoginis, I really got frightened about it. So don't get carried away that, oh, your psychic ability is great, and claiming yourself at Guru Padmasambhava level, Lord Krishna level, and all that thing. That is not at all possible. Please accept the humbleness and try to practice more and more. Many people require years of practice even before they can bring the energy into their hands. Now, such is their level and their ability, but many people fail to understand that these all require time, focus, discipline, and they are not very lucky in their life to have started early. They have started very late. So why don't you stop wasting your time and having the focus to do the sadhana every day in your free time than talking about all big things in your life. So this is the problem with many people. So psychic ability, clairvoyance, the third eye has to fully open. You can use the mantras to open it, you can use visualization to open it, but it is going to take time. Because you do Shambhavi Mudra half an hour, it does not mean you are very spiritual or holy cat. There's a guy who came to me and he said, I have had Kundalini awakening twice, will I get moksha about it? I started laughing and I said, it is like they call it a samsara sagara. Imagine yourself carrying the ocean of life. It is so difficult, it is so tough. Why do you think it's so easy? Many people want their life to be easy because their spiritual life is not going to be easy. They think they can get moksha, jnana just like that without any effort, and because they are thinking all the time that there are great beings of light. It is far from truth. In fact, it is easier to win a Wimbledon, easier to win an Olympic gold medal. It is very, very difficult to get enlightened because the ignorance has to die, because your understanding has to increase. You have to look, whole world as a set of illusion which is happening. Now, illusion is long-term illusion, short-term reality. Impermanence is long-term. Now, for example, in your younger days, was it true? Yes, it was true. But right now it is true? No. So the point is, a process of evolution is currently it is true, long term it is impermanent. So unless you are able to understand these things across, it is not going to be very, very easy. So don't waste your time in projecting psychic abilities which are not true. That is why many healers become sick. Many healers do not have a good health. I know one lady who got cancer, breast cancer, because she was treating somebody with breast cancer. So don't develop all those things. Align yourself with the truth. Satyam eva jayate. You'll realize you require a lot of practice, less of talking, and one day God will send people to appreciate you. God will send people to make you that you are good. Whatever you're doing good, there will be an appreciation which will be coming across. You don't need to appreciate, you don't need to promote, you don't need to tell yourself. This is a misunderstanding which many people have. So don't try to con yourself in many, many ways in telling you have a psychic abilities which are far from truth. Many people, intuition itself is not awakened. Forget about opening the third eye, seeing the spirit, overcoming time barriers, doing astral travel. These are considered as a Mahasiddhi, and many people take years to come into the reality across. I pray God that may you align with the truth, may your practice deepen. Thank you.